My best wishes and paripurna ashirvadams to all the viewers of Sri Venkateswara Bhakthi Channel. May the Almighty Sri Lord Venkateswara bestow all kinds of prosperity, health, wealth and eternal happiness with paripurna lakshmi kataksham to you and the entire your family members and friends. Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, verse number 26th of 6th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Yato Yato Nishcharati Manaschanchalam Asthiram Tatastato Niyam Yaitata Atmanyeva Vashamnayeta. Our mind is everything in our life because we do all the transactions through our mind, whether it is happy or sadness or jealous or hatred, everything is experienced by our mind. Without emotions, there are no mind. So mind is everything. Now the mind has been divided in Western countries as three layers, like a conscious mind, subconscious mind and unconscious mind. So now we are going to analyze this one session. I'm going to spend comparing both the theory from our Sanatana Dharma and the concept of those Westerners. And even those Westerners, they also depend on our Sanatana Dharma in order to derive at a conclusion, proper conclusion about our mind. So mind itself is known as a conscious mind. So they add a word that is a conscious, that consciousness also endowed with, backed up by the past emotions and memory and everything. Now if you want to perform a simple action saying good morning to somebody, when somebody says you good morning sir, you say, and they should also reply. If they are not replying, your good morning becomes not valid. So now mind becomes, you know, more active to think why he didn't reply me, what was wrong, yesterday I was doing correct. And was there anything wrong that I did? So many thoughts it arises, you know, you want to get a proper answer. So it doesn't provide any answer. It will keep bugging. It will wait up to the next day. You may be engaged with lots of the work. Doesn't matter. Next day when he looks at you, it happens to see again. Again the mind brings attached expectations. Today your good morning has become little bit down. Good morning sir. If he replies with enthusiasm, hello sir, how are you, good morning, very very good morning, how are you, then your mind will work, you know, it will compare, oh, yesterday he was not giving proper reply or response, today what happened to him. That's what our mind's nature. The nature of the mind has to be understood thoroughly by a meditator. The conscious mind always deals with the current matters. Okay? It doesn't have the memory capacity. It knows how to express whatever that comes. It knows only to express what to be done, and that expressions, everything is supported by subconscious mind. Therefore this conscious mind, sometimes it becomes a slave of subconscious mind. This conscious mind also be endowed with a logical thinking, but that logical thinking sometimes it goes beyond that, because like a blind, you know, you respond to somebody who is not fighting with you, but you become aggressive with that somebody. He can. So that is because of what? Subconscious mind. This conscious mind and subconscious mind has to be realized well. The conscious mind is only 10% which is visible. This is like a upper part of a sea. The middle part of a sea is known as a subconscious mind. Then the deep sea is known as unconscious mind. Your habitual, your everyday action doing makes a kind of impact. That impact which is registered in our subconscious mind, it goes down. All the memories, like a phone number, names, color, the incidents, the experiences, everything is stored in, slowly it's stored in subconscious mind, not as the data. You have to be very careful, because when we collect, that is in the form of data. But when it is stored, it is mixed up with the emotions. Because very thoroughly we have made the research over the subconscious mind. But subconscious mind which doesn't have the time conscious, and subconscious mind in which it doesn't know the difference between past and present and future. It knows only present. But the conscious mind alone can say whether it is past or future or present. If we are talking about something which had happened yesterday, the conscious mind alone will judge, confirm that incident is not now, it was in the past. And something, you know, in future, what is going to be there? So if you are going to demonstrate a play, so you are sitting in a place and just you are imagining that play, whoever the character, you are the writer of that play and you made so many characters with you. So for example, if you want to play Ramayana, just you become Rama or you become Ravana or Lakshmana and all the other characters. So who comes when, what the scenes and everything. So subconscious mind doesn't know this is an imagination. Now the subconscious mind is a completely blind to the time tenses. Present, past and future, it knows only present tense. That also it doesn't confirm as a present tense. It cannot define the difference between the real happening or dream or imagination. The subconscious mind, because today I am comparing with all the theory of Western and Eastern and whatever the theory made by our Indian scriptures. The subconscious mind which becomes yajamana, you know, yajamana means owner to the conscious mind. The conscious mind, it is very much conscious, but it becomes inable a person when subconscious mind drives it. Many of the time subconscious mind alone rides the conscious mind. Conscious mind becomes, though with the very consciousness state, it loses the control over the action. So one person I know, whenever somebody says you are a genius, he will fight like anything with him. Actually he is genius. He is a computer person. He knows all kinds of system in the computer. Whatever the problem, he corrects immediately. My God, his brain is so fast. At the same time, he is very intelligent in so many subjects. Even he has by-hearted whole Ramayana in Sanskrit shloka. His mind is, my God, it's a wonder. So that person, if somebody says, you are such a genius, immediately he will fight like anything that, so what are you thinking about me? How can you say that? So once it happened in front of me. So when somebody said, you are nothing but genius, then he becomes so emotionalist. He cannot fight with that person because that person was very elderly and senior most person. But he became so tensed, depressed, and he went out and he was not there for a long time. When he entered again to that hall, his eyes were red and he was not the normal person. Then I called him the next day, what had happened? So what went wrong? He said, in order to encourage you, and what he said was right, you are that person. I didn't use the word, because I know somewhere the mind is locked. Now subconscious does the riding over the conscious mind. The subconscious becomes a completely blind, the helpless, hopeless person during that action. Therefore, many people, they go out of control. They are going out of control means what? Subconscious mind rides over the conscious mind. So you have to catch hold my language, because riding over conscious mind means it becomes conscious mind. That's what you say, that no, conscious mind remains the conscious mind, but the emotions are occupied, which are supplied by the subconscious mind, because the subconscious mind alone the life. So in order to realize this, you have to have a little bit patience. Now I tell you, after that, what I did was, with that person, I called him back to my ashram. Then we had a long discussion. Finally, I came to know. I didn't do any mesmerizing or hypnotize to that person. Just I had a conversation. I asked about his childhood incidents. Then I learned this younger brother, so who were not that much intelligent than him. So he used to criticize whenever he invents something. He shows something very talented things. So he used to criticize, so junior aa gaya, so junior has come, so he is very junior, so give all the credibility to him. So this criticism, which was made when he was growing with new ideas, so which was not recognized by the surrounding people, even not parents. So parents alone encouraged him, parents alone did all, they made all kinds of environment, by that he grew that to be a genius. But the environment, you know, slow, the group, friend circle, the brother and brother's friend circle, so they started doing this criticism. Therefore what? So all incidents have gone. Now the impact remains in the subconscious mind, it overrides now and then. He has achieved a lot, he has recognized by even governor and even by our CMR, I suppose by president, he was honored by the president, but still he was, you know, hanging over that one word. Then I made a simple statement, your subconscious mind is overriding on your conscious mind, be aware. Then he asked what to be done for that. No, just be aware, it will go slowly. And after 6 months he said, no, I'm not getting nowadays this kind of uncontrolled actions. Then I said, the observance, to you have to observe, you have to find where the problem is. Now the conscious mind, which is very important, the conscious mind, which is conscious about time and space, also which uses the logical thing, but subconscious mind doesn't have logical approach even. If you imagine something, it will think that it is happening now. Therefore what? The subconscious mind, according to the theory of these Westerners, and those people, they have confirmed, some of the people, subconscious mind, whatever it thinks, it brings back. If you imagine something, you will get that something. If you want to become a billionaire, millionaire, you have to imagine that you are already billionaire, millionaire. If you want to become a very famous person, you have to imagine already you have become like that a famous person. If you want to become like a very successful figure in the society, you have to imagine already you have become, because this is, they say, the subconscious mind will believe and it will bring. The subconscious mind is everything to bring it. Then what about the unconscious mind? This unconscious mind, so every incident which was stored with emotional things, it also stored, so that storage, it becomes completely unaware by the conscious mind. Even subconscious mind will help you to get the memories, but unconscious mind has become your complete nature. In our Sanatana Dharma, we call it Vasana. So Vasana means, So very forceful, strong, driving force, that which makes a slave to every action, your conscious mind becomes hopeless. Even subconscious mind stuck in front of unconscious mind. This subconscious mind is nothing but the registration of the transaction which is as an experienced. Now, when you go to out of your country, going abroad, staying there for 6 months, so you can see your subconscious mind, how it struggles to adapt new things. Your conscious mind also, though your conscious mind is normal, your subconscious mind is not normal, because it adapts very slowly the circumstances. It rewrites the old habitual things, because it needs to have the regular food. If you are a South Indian, you crave for rice, rasam, idli, sambar, dosa. If you are a North Indian, you crave for roti, and you also crave for this palak paneer, paneer butter masala. So these things won't be available abroad. It will crave for that fruit, that food, and whatever that edible things, whatever that entertainment you used to get, it will crave like anything. And after a certain period of time, it is overwritten. When you come back to India, you will be, you know, craving for those things. You will go once in a week to eat pizza because you have rewritten it. Now the life is writing on the subconscious mind. Unknowingly we transact, but mind writes over a page. A page, whenever you think it comes like a computer, but it is, you know, the crores time more than the computer. The computer has been defined by having the sense of the psychological system alone. Our psychological system, which is very valuable, even it can bring all the connectivity from the last birth. Now the conscious mind, which becomes a very tiny role to play in every circumstances with every incidence. If you say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, see this good morning, it is, though it is coming from conscious mind, it is supplied by subconscious mind and driven and completely supported by unconscious mind. Finally, what the in a day, in the 24 hours, you work for 16 hours, we will take in that way. Among the 16 hours, all the 16 hours transaction are not stored in the subconscious mind. So that which impacts, affects emotionally, it is stored. Because it happens to see so many things in our life, all the things are not stored. That what you wish a lot, so what the connection that you have a lot, that alone stored. Now the mind is nothing but stored material. This is what the concept from the Western country. And they have improved a lot now. They are also talking about the Supreme Consciousness. The Supreme Consciousness, nothing to do with this, but because of that presence, you know, that presence means the Supreme Consciousness presence alone, this unconsciousness, subconscious, a conscious mind can work. So this is the system, but Sanatana Dharma, I'm coming now again. Sanatana Dharma says, your thoughts are popping out every time, because when the object comes in front of you, you are setting a thought. The regular example, when a mango comes in front of you, you set the mango thought. When a bike comes in front of you, you get the bike thought. When a ship comes in front of you, or you go in front of the ship, you get the ship thought. And when a bird flies in front of you, you get the bird thought. That's because of you think The thoughts are because of the object which comes in front. But our Sanatana Dharma says, even the objects are brought in front of you, or you are taken in front of that, is because of your psychological system. So you may wonder, and in a simple word, karma phala. So all concept made as a small word, karma phala. Your karma phala brings any object in front of you in order to fructify the experience, in order to give the experience to you. When an object comes, you set the thought, you interact with the thought, you gain the experience, you make more impact on your thought, it becomes cycle. We don't divide as upper layer, middle layer, or the layer which in the deep sea. We just say that the mind is chittam, that's all, one word. And there also we define ahankaram, chittam, manas, buddhi, ahankaram, these four words. The karma palla. So when my karma palla has given this body and the body has got the memory, that memory, all of them which are loaded with the emotions, all these memories in the form of vritti, they come out with the emotions from the past birth. In the past birth, I had the sharira and the karma palla. So there I had lots of experiences. Those experiences exist in the form of subtle memory. So that memory works in this computer. Those memory alone brings again and again those objects. Therefore, my mind becomes a slave. Now, when you realize like this, you won't be victimized. Any incident happens outside, you need to have a broad mind to accept it. It looks so simple. When I say conscious mind, subconscious mind, unconscious mind, wow, what a language, what the teaching, what the divisions, what how they divide. So you become wonder. But in our place, in our Sanatana Dharma, it makes very simple. Your vasana continues. All this unconscious mind, what they say, we call it just mind. Everything exists in you. But everything exists in you, you have to support them, otherwise they cannot do anything. That is the teaching. Now mind goes by seeing an object, because it's karma phala, yato yato nischarati. Because the tendency or nature of the mind has to go out. If any object comes, it goes and stick with that. Even it is said, when an object comes in front of your eyes travel, the eyesight travel to that object in order to capture the data of that object. But the science says that the object reflects in our eye glass or retina, whatever it is. So there we have got a kind of lens, it is reflected. So that reflection is creating a vritti. But in our Sanatana Dharma, so the eyesight goes. Therefore we become tired. You watch three movies together in a day. Continuously you observe and watch whatever it is in the TV, continuously don't do, even not moving a single bit of places. Just keep watching, you will become tired. Because the movie is feeding your eyes and even feeding your mind, feeding your ears. Therefore what? You are emotionally loaded, feeded, then your prana are spent. All the power, the energy, the pranic energy is spent. You become tired, you need to have a long sleep to regain it. We talk about the pranas. The pranas are the fuel for our mind to work. If there is no prana, it will keep a silent computer. If you have prana, if pranas are supplied, it will become like a seed when it is not sprouting, so it is there like even for hundreds of years. Again you will give your sow on the land, it will come up. The same way, the mind exists in the seed form. The mind exists in the seed form means, as we call it, whatever the name, we call it vasana. All the vasanas are existing in your mind. It brings all the incidents, similar like a Western thoughts. So, but in the different technical terms, everything is because of your karma pala. Your body is given, your parents are selected, even friends were selected, your language was selected, everything was selected. You are kept in a place to enjoy one incident, means you will be kept there. If you want to have one experience, if you want to get hit on the shoulders on the particular street, you will be taken there. Doesn't matter whether you are in South Africa, America, London, France, Japan, you will be brought to that particular street in India, you will be given that experience. Now you have to have, everything is because of my karma pala. Means what? It is already written. I have to rewritten it. That rewriting is known as dharana. When you contemplate outside, you are writing in different way. Again, your mind is taken out. Therefore, drive the mind towards you. Turn the mind, the attention of mind, the flow of mind has to be turned. And it has to be established in I. Then what happens? Whatever is written, the world is created because of our karma pala, cannot do anything. Because that entity is known as akarma. Karmanya karmaya pashyet. Akarmanaja karmaya sabuddhiman manushyeshu. So, sayukta krastana karma krat. So, akarma, when you establish over that, this all become validless. Because of that aham alone, they are valid. The presence of I alone, they are activated. When you are establishing yourself in that, so everything, they may continue because of karma pala. They don't bother you. But you need to have training. Wherever, in whatever the cause mind goes, bring it back. Just having the understanding, they are created by my vasana. I am the author. They cannot do anything. They cannot impact me. Because when you press the accelerator and the brake, you know, we do the same. When we want to control the mind, we press the accelerator and press the brake too. What will happen? The engine will collapse. Controlling the mind without the knowledge, without proper methodology, it becomes more dangerous than before. The mind, you know, when you make one intelligent decision in order to drink a coffee, first time when you want to drink a coffee, you make a decision through your intelligence. Then day by day, day by day, day by day, day by day, that decision is practiced. Okay? After 6 months or 1 year, if you make again the decision that I would stop, you cannot stop. Because it has become emotional thing. You have become addicted to that. Now your mind won't allow. Then what should be done? You have to rewrite on that. You have to relive on that. Whenever you want to get a coffee, you have to give something else on the time. These are all habitual mistakes. It has to be rewritten. So once you realize you are nothing but Atma, you may not get the benefit what to be got. So once you realize you become one with everything, you have to be away from all kinds of sorrow. You should be mukta purushaha, mukta sangonaham vadi. So like you have to be completely Satchid Ananda Vastu. But many people are not able to experience the fruit because of habitual mistake. So you have to rewrite that writing again is known as the meditation dharana. We'll continue in the next session tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.